fuck you doing up here? Help goes into the back.
I'm here to see Mr. Marcano. The name's Lincoln Clay.
That a fact? I'll be goddamned. Mind your manners while you're in there, boy, or there'll be hell to pay, you hear?
Lincoln Clay! Christ, man, get a look at you! I bet those fucking gooks shit themselves when they saw you coming.
Been a long time, Georgie.
Oh, no shit, it's been a long time. I think the last time I saw you was that night over in the French Ward, right before you shipped out. Damn, if that wasn't a gas.
Oh, I seem to remember me and Ellis running from the cops, and Danny ending up in the drunk tank.
Hell, man, I bailed him out. Besides, it was worth it to knock the hell out of them cracker assholes. Smoke?
Sure.
Oh, man.
Sammy said Mr. Marcano wanted to see me.
Mr. Marcano? Shit. Make him sound like a goddamn lawyer. You just call him Sal. Come on, he's in the back.
I should have wore something else.
Hey, these squares have a problem with your threads. You can take it up with my old man. He'll tell him to kiss his ass. Nice thing about having fuck you money.
Olivia, I hate to cut this short, darling, but I've got a meeting coming up. Remy, a pleasure as always, sir. Two more glasses.
Lincoln, good to see you. This is Vito Scaletta. He's the one I've been telling you about. Come on, Lincoln, sit down.
So you served in Vietnam, huh?
Yes, sir.
Sal tells me you earned a few pieces of tin over there.
Well, I served with some good men. Nothing I did would have happened without them.
Army? Marines?
Regular Army at first, and then I was recruited to the 5th SFG.
Special Forces.
I told you it was something else. Now, not that anything's gonna go wrong, but just in case, goddamn, don't you want a man like that on your side?
Well, if you're vouching for him, Sal, that's good enough for me. Look, I got a couple things to take care of. Thanks for the drink.
Christ, that guy's an asshole. Fucking carpetbagger. Commission sent him down here from Empire Bay about 15 years back. He's been a pain in my goddamn ass ever since. Well, I guess you're wondering what this is all about.
Yeah, Sammy didn't tell me too much.
Twice a year, the feds take old money out of circulation and destroy it. Over the course of the next few days, that money's gonna be delivered here to the reserve in town.
And you're gonna hit one of those shipments?
No, sir. We are gonna use that occasion to gain access to their vault.
And then steal everything that ain't nailed down. Should be $6-7 million in there, easy.
That's pretty fucking ballsy.
It's a chance of a goddamn lifetime is what it is.
Now, Vito's fronting a lot of the money for the job, and he got us the combination to the vault. Hey, you had a chance to see Danny?
No, not yet.
Oh, well, you will. We brought him and his old man in on this, and they're gonna need your help, so go see them. They're still in that same place.
There's something else we gotta talk about. Now, safe to assume you know about the problem Sammy's been having.
I took care of the Haitians. Once things settle down, money will start coming in again.
You see that right there? That's what I'm talking about. You didn't sit around with your thumb jammed in your ass. You saw a problem, you went out and took care of it. Goddamn, I'd take that over money any day of the week.
We pay our own way, debts and all. Always have.
Oh, hell, son, I know that. I wouldn't expect otherwise. But you know, even after we all evened up, you're still gonna be slopping around in the ass end of this city. Not much of a future in that. But maybe there's a different way forward, you understand? For all of us.
What'd you have in mind?
I want you to know I mean no disrespect when I say this. Sammy's a hell of a man, but he's not getting any younger. And I'm thinking it's time to make a change.
Well, I don't think that Ellis is ready for that kind
of stuff. I'm not talking about Ellis. I'm talking about you. I want you to run the holler.
I can't do that.
Well, look here. If you're worried about Sammy, don't you understand? Now, he's always been on the level with me. And this job we're talking about, there's more than enough for him to retire on.
He took me in when I had nowhere else to go. Treated me like a son. I'm sorry, Mr. Marcano. I can't do that to him.
Well, shit, son. I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't just a little disappointed. But I get it. You're loyal. Which is something that is scarce these days.
Do you still want me to help with this thing we've been talking about?
You goddamn right I do! And when it's all done, you all be more than square with me. You have my word.
What do you really want to hear? That we'd kidnap and torture anyone suspected of working with the VC? I'm trying to ascertain the level of training that Lincoln Clay received during his time in Vietnam. Someone like that you don't need to train. You point them in the right direction, you get the fuck out of their way.
Gotta be somewhere. Let's just keep looking.
Goddamn thing.
Neither can they. Stay cool. We'll get through this.
Motherfuckers.
He's right there. Look for cover.
Damn massacre.
Help me up. Somebody help me.
God damn it.
Lincoln! Drills bust through!
Mama, I'm bleeding bad.
Hot damn, Alice. What took you cats so long?
Piece of shit drill kept overheating. You and Lincoln both still in one piece?
Yeah, we good. Where's Danny?
He's pushing everything off to the side so that we have room to catch some money.
All right, well, once you squared away up here, we start dropping it down.
Well, make it quick.
Motherfuckers killed the lights.
Just worry about the money. I'll deal with this.
Got him. Suspect's on the move. Trapped.
Drop him. Keep this asshole once we're
dead. Oh, shit. Taking it.
They're trying to flush us out. Stay focused on what you're doing.
Where you come from?
What's he think he's doing?
Get locked this place down!
This is a goddamn massacre!
I'm itching to kill you!
Point me at him!
God damn it, those guards will cut us down the second we make a break for it. Tell Danny he needs to get us out of here.
Hey, these bastards got us pinned down. Y'all need to figure something out.
I got some TNT. I'll put on outside the hole and detonate it.
What the fuck is that gonna accomplish?
With any luck, it'll blow a hole big enough for y'all to drop down.
With any luck, Danny, do you even know what the fuck you're doing?
Come on, it's dynamite. How complicated could it be? It's lit. Get the fuck away from the hole.
Thank you.
Ellis!
I'm trying! Danny's leg is pinned! I need your help!
No one really knows why Sal Marcano turned on Thomas Burke, but he took Point Verdun from him and gave it to an enforcer named Roman the Butcher Barbieri, who promptly busted up one of Burke's legs. Now, Danny Burke was part of the heist crew. I mean, he was a gearhead, had never done anything like this before, but Thomas Burke insisted. He figured if the heist was a success, Sal would forgive him and return Point Verdun.
Traitor, all right.
Hey. Now, I heard there ain't nothing sweeter than Vietnamese pussy. You tell me it's true. Casanova Clay. Shit, man, it's so fucking good to see you.
You too, Danny. How's Nikki?
Damn, she wanted to be here, but I ain't remember how old I was. God damn, you piece of shit!
Yeah, unfortunately.
Come on, let's grab a beer. Wait for the old man to chill out, and then we can get down to it.
Yeah. What's up, man?
You already got it all set up and organized. All the girls gonna be there and everything, except we just gotta go in my cars because we can't roll up in that beat-up piece of shit outside.
Oh, you didn't just call my all-American machine a beater?
I'm just saying, there are better rides out there.
Hey, bullshit there are. This car's a beast. I dropped a custom 358 and a four shipped out.
That ain't the only thing you dropped in her. Maybe you should tell them about how you'd borrow it from Ellis and take the ladies for a ride.
Hell, man, leave me out of this.
Did you fuck in my car?
Mm-hmm. Nah, it ain't no big deal. I was always wrapped up tight. Besides, I already got one fucking bastard in my life. I don't need another one.
All right, you know what? You're going to clean it. Not just the back seat. Every square inch. I don't need to be riding around sitting in your shit. Hey, and you, funny man, you going to fucking help?
Like hell I am. Shit, I didn't get any.
Yeah, well, this is new.
Jesus Christ, you fucking Joker's got about as much chance of pulling this off as I do at winning a goddamn decathlon.
All right, Dad, we hear you.
Danny and Ellis, you're gonna use the drill to cut a hole up through the bottom of the vault. You and Georgie, you'll be inside. You're to drop the money down, then get the hell out of there. That goddamn drill ain't easy to move, though. So we need a boat to get it through the canals and into position.
Well, Ellis and I worry about the boat. See, George's old man flipped the guard at the reserve, giving you his truck.
Between that and the uniforms, ain't no one gonna give us a second look. Come on, let's get moving. We still gotta swing by Skeletta's and finish up some prep work.
Hey, and you two assholes, don't think this gets you off the hook when it comes to my car. Y'all best get ready to clean it.
I ain't cleaning shit.
Hey, you cleaning it.
My father was a lot of things, few of them good. But he started out smuggling moonshine, so he knew about the canals underneath the city, and that one of them went right under the Federal Reserve. It was his idea to use a boat to move the drill into position. He was a real son of a bitch, my father. More than anyone else, I blame him for what happened. You want to stick your own neck out, fine. But leave your son out of it. It's his fault Danny died.
Is everyone in? We need to go.
We're all here. Go. Hold it.
Guards coming down through the hall. Fuck, more guards. We need to get the truck out of here.
Motherfuckers! Cops cutting up our escape route!
We'll find another way out of here. This tunnel has to go somewhere.
It's the fucking cops!
Lined up! Ready to fire!
Come on then, you sister fucking cunt! You don't fuck with Georgie Marco!
Georgie, you gagged him?
Here they come!
Son of a bitch, got me!
Keep going! Don't slow down! Fuck you, you goddamn cock-sucking rat fucker! Right, punch it, Lincoln!
Are you out of your fucking mind? Fuck, fuck, fuck!
Everybody all right?
That was the craziest fucking thing I've ever saw.
Oh, I'm glad we're breathing and all, but what the hell are we gonna do now?
Only option is to head up.
Are you kidding me? There'll be cops all over the place.
Well, with any luck, they'll be too busy dealing with Mardi Gras. Notice us. Let's go.
Well, damn it, this ain't a gas.
Hey, you sure you need to grab that much of my ass?
Oh, shut up and keep climbing, man.
Okay, give me a hand.
All right.
Okay. Come on.
We got you.
All right, once we get out there, I hit a payphone. Call us in a ride.
Can you walk?
Yeah, somebody give me a hand. I can get one.
It's probably just gonna be easier to carry a sorry ass. Hold up. Come here.
Hey! Don't put me the fuck down!
If anybody asks, we say he's drunk. Y'all pick up that money. Let's go.
Oh, God damn it.
Titties on her.
Hey, darling, you looking for a good time?
Danny, keep it down. No, actually, you get a look at her titties? I mean, God damn.
Damn it, shut your mouth before you get us arrested.
Stop, God damn it, stop! Fuck you, pig!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, man, get off the phone. Right fucking now.
I insist that you apologize.
Y'all keep an eye out. We're in some deep shit and need your help.
Where are you?
Just off the parade route. Danny's hurt.
I can't get a car to you because the roads are closed off. Listen, there's a grocery store on the backside of the cemetery. Can you get over there?
Yeah.
There'll be a car waiting at the loading dock. And Lincoln, be careful, yeah?
Hey.
You and that escort.
We will. Sammy's having a car delivered. It'll be at the loading dock at the grocery store.
God bless the old man.
Where you going?
Let's go.
Your pardon. Hey, careful.
Cut through the bar, Lincoln.
Cocksucking cops tell me the party's over. I'll tell you when the goddamn party's over.
An untold number of federal officers were killed today when two gunmen robbed the Federal Reserve.
Fuck, you hear that? We made the news! Shut the fuck up, Georgie, we need to keep moving!
I'm telling you for the last fucking time, you need to tell me what you did with the purse.
I already done told you.
Both units in the robbery was found abandoned beneath the French Ward. All units respond. Suspects are a Negro male, approximately 6'4", a white male, approximately 5'11", and two unknown accomplices. They are armed and extremely dangerous.
Fuck, they found the boat!
Stay cool, man. We're still good.
That's not what she's saying.
He ain't dead! Get a doctor!
Careful!
There's something wrong with
that. Stay in line.
My friend here can't handle his booze.
Not cool.
What are we gonna do?
Ellis.
Fucking pigs are everywhere.
Ellis, chill out. Everything's gonna be fine.
All right, you guys take Danny and the money. Get to the car. I'll deal with the cops. I'll warn them off you.
Hey, no fucking way, man.
It's all right. He ain't going alone. We all got a friend, Jesus.
Amen.
All right, let's go.
Where's Georgie?
We got separated before we lost sight of him. He said he'd meet us back at the house. Get in!
035, suspicious person in vehicle. Responding unit investigated. On scene, officers engaging with suspect. Respond with caution.
I think this boy matches the suspect.
None of this makes any sense. That can't be how it happened.
Sleeping on a bed of titties. I don't care what it fucking costs.
They're right behind us!
Suspect located. On-scene units engaging.
They gone?
Yeah, man, they done.
I knew we could pull it off, I knew it! We're rich, fuck!
I'm robbing people with a six-gun.
I bought the law,
and the law can kiss my ass.
I fought the law, and the law lost.
How much is it?
A little over $2 million. Per split.
Holy mother God.
Once everything's settled up, I'm calling the man I know, having him bring over 3 hookers.
Boy, ain't no hooker ever stepping foot in this house.
You sure? Because 2 of them are for you.
I'm gonna be fucking in my new Drifter.
I'd appreciate that.
You know, my entire life, there's always been someone standing over me, telling me where I could go, what I could do, who I could be seen with. This. What you boys did tonight. This changes everything. This isn't just money. It's freedom. Real freedom. Ain't no one standing over me again. Over any of us. Huh? Vouloir c'est pouvoir, eh?
Vouloir c'est pouvoir!
Well, well, well.
Oh, look man, at the man. Look at the man.
There he is. Oh. And look at what I dug up.
You mind pouring one more of those?
Holy shit.
It'll be my pleasure.
Georgie told me shit went sideways during the robbery. Lincoln had to save your ass. You should be damn proud of that, boy.
I am, Sal. More than you'll ever know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that is some down-home hooch right there, isn't it?
All right.
Listen, I got a guy outside. Y'all mind if he comes in and packs up my cut?
Not at all.
Look at that. Let's see if you can handle this down-home hooch.
Yeah, why don't you give me some of that?
Trying to get some corn whiskey, make you a man.
They all the same.
Hey, take the one on the end. It's your cut, plus what I owe you. Even put in a little extra for your trouble.
Couldn't have pulled it off without you, Sammy. Y'all done right by me tonight. Mwah. Mwah. Why don't you get us some off the top shelf? We need to celebrate.
Yeah. You ain't got to tell me,
yeah.
Twice.
Hey, fill me up. All right.
Know something, Lincoln? You're possibly the baddest motherfucker I ever laid my eyes on. You shouldn't have said no.
Where the fuck you think you're going? Fucking niggas.
Go on, grab that back. Let's go.
When I got to Sammy's, the whole place was burning. I still don't know what brought me there that night. Luck? Divine providence? Or something else? Out of the fire, he woke up long enough to tell me to call John Donovan. So that's what I did. Most days I wish I'd never made that call.
Mr. Donovan, do you know this individual?
Sure. It's Sal Marcano.
Mm-hmm. And how about this man?
That's Sal's worthless piece of shit brother, Lou. Look, enough of the dog and pony bullshit. What's your real question?
Did you help Lincoln Clay murder Sal Marcano and all prominent members of his crime family?
You're goddamn right I did. I see the moon rising. I see trouble on the way.
I see earthquakes and lightning. I see
So those the men you're gonna kill, huh?
That's the plan, Padre.
It's a dangerous course you're contemplating.
And what do you think we should do?
Sal Marcano deserves to die. I won't argue otherwise. Kill him. But let that be the end of it.
That's not enough!
It's enough if you say it's enough. I know what Sal did to you, Lincoln. But nothing you do will bring any of them back.
This isn't about bringing them back, or even exacting some street justice. It's about making that bastard feel what it's like to lose everything. Watch as I take it all away from him.
This is a one-way road, Lincoln. And once you start down it, there ain't no turning back.
I'm going to Sammy's to get my stuff. You ready?
I'll be waiting in the car.
Taught us kids to turn the other cheek, not fight back. Problem is, that don't work. Not in the real world.
Lincoln, we should get going. The Padre doesn't seem too keen on the plan.
You don't need to worry about him.
I'd just hate to encounter any of that Catholic guilt I'm always hearing about.
He knows every low-life thing I've ever done and has never ratted me out. If I say we can trust him, we can trust him.
Fair enough. So you mind telling me what we're really doing?
I'm gonna kill Marcano and all the assholes who work for him.
Bullshit. If that's all you're after, you'd grab an XM-21, smear on some face paint, and they'd all be dead before dinner. And you sure as hell wouldn't need a TACOP center and all this other shit you've asked me for.
After I got back, Marcano offered me the Harlem, said it was time for Sammy to retire. After I got back, Marcano offered me the Harlem, said it was time for Sammy to retire. I told him no.
So you think what happened is your fault?
Hard to see it otherwise.
What do you think Sal was going to do? Host a little party for Sammy? Maybe give him a gold watch and a plaque congratulating him on his retirement? We both know there's only one way out of the life. And you still haven't answered my question.
I'm gonna take over the city, district by district. Marcano wanted me to run the Harlem? Fuck him. By the time I'm done, I'll be running the whole goddamn city.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. Assuming, of course, you're up for something that strenuous.
Why the fuck wouldn't I be?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe because you got shot in the face?
I might have lost a step or two, but it'll come back to me. Always does.
God, if that isn't the fucking truth. Are you doing
one other thing?
Probably not much. What was I talking about?
I don't always assume that.
Just being diligent. The cops see you fighting Sal's goons. They're coming after you, every time. Sure you don't need a ride?
Nah, man, I'm good.
I'll be at the motel. Come see me when you're ready.
Hello? Thank you.
son.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
Hey, bullshit there are. This guy's a beast.
I want you to run the hall.
Shouldn't have said no.
What the fuck?
Boys dying over there in Vietnam.
There's something I gotta do.
I ever tell you how I got this?
Sure, you stole it.
That I did. I let the pocket of this old white man used to come around here raising him. Take this with you. There's always brought me good luck.
I can't do that.
I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln. But you're not. And you never will be.
About the Hollow's old Sammy Robinson. Not just a leader, but also inspiration within our community. Along with his son, Ellis.
You weren't lying about setting up a tax center.
The key to running a successful black bag operation is plausible deniability. Which is why I stole all this shit from the FBI. Things go tits up, those chicken dicks can deal with the fallout.
Glad to see you haven't lost your touch.
If there's one thing I'm good at, it's fucking with Hoover's Ferry Brigade. And while you were convalescing, I did some digging around. Wanted to see if there are any local assets for you to recruit. I came up with three possibilities.
Right now, my priority is getting the Hollow out from whoever ended up with it.
Figured as much.
Haitians? Well, I thought they fell apart after I put Baca down.
Lucky for us, they're back up. And they're none too pleased that Sal gave Delray Hollow to the Dixie Mafia.
Dixie Mafia?
Georgie's idea. He's got him running heroin, trying to get everybody hooked.
Motherfucker. I'll be damned if I let those coon asses destroy everything that Sammy built up. Who replaced Baca?
Unknown. Managed to keep his identity a secret.
Unknown? Even to John Donovan? Never thought I'd see the day.
Well, I can't help it if I was born pigmentally challenged.
So, you telling me my only option is to tail one of these Haitians? Hope he leads me back to the mysterious leader?
Hey, it's better than no options. And once you've ingratiated yourself with them, you come see me. I'm finishing something up you're gonna want to see.
I'm not ignorant to the realities of the business that Sammy Robinson ran. But was a criminal. Yeah. He was a criminal. No denying that. If you did him wrong, you were...
Heard they're flying James L. Ray back this week. Still amazes me they expect us to believe it was one man who did end Dr. King.
It's too easy. Too pat.
Let's say he was the one who shot Dr. King. Just him and no one else. What if it's really that easy to strike down a great man like Dr. King, President Kennedy, Brother Malcolm?
Then nothing in this country will ever change.
Now you struggle and you sweat and someone can take it all away just like that, huh?
Huh? Looking good, chocolate pudding. Maybe you can give me a taste later on.
You go to hell.
Been 3 years, man.
She was my fixy cocksuckers when they shit like clockwork.
And we about to take them apart piece by fucking piece.
If that don't work, we just take a sledgehammer to the whole goddamn thing.
For true. The thing that surprises me the most is how much these crackers love black pussy.
These crackers look
bad. Shit's going down. No trace. Let's check in there.
We got to...
We all want Dixie out of the hollow. Give me your boss and I'll make it happen.
Fuck. Shit. Get to the voodoo shop. You'll find the boss there.
Sorry about the headache, brother.
Hello? Time to go!
I got you!
Shoot somebody, we're gonna have the pigs up our asses.
Among us who believe the only path to success is by breaking the law. But there is one set of laws you cannot break, and that's the laws of God.
café?
Nice trick you pulled back at the Haitian camp, pretending Baca was holding you prisoner.
And I held you while dead. It appears we both full of surprises.
Certainly does.
What can I do for you, Lincoln Clay?
I want you to help me kill Sal Marcano.
I see. A few months ago, you was trying to kill me. Now you break in here and expect me to trust you?
Now that Marcano's backing the Dixie Mafia, it's only a matter of time till they come for you. And when they do, they'll kill everyone standing in their way.
Lest I hitch my horse to your wagon, so to speak.
I'll see to it that you get the hollow. After that, depends on how things shake out.
Do you know why Sammy and I were at war?
On account of you going after the lottery?
Please. Just because you don't want to face some uncomfortable truths ain't a reason to act naive. Sammy and I were fighting because the people in Dahala deserve better than a two-faced old man who handed out cans of food whenever the mood hit him. Who always did what Sal Marcano told him to do, even if it pitted him against his own people.
He did the best he could.
And yet his best didn't amount to much, did it? Once I have the holler, I run it as I see fit. No questions asked.
Long as you give me access to your muscle, your connections, and a place to hold up from time to time, you can do what you want.
Marcano replaced Sammy with a man named Richie Doucette. Do you know of him?
Assume he's Dixie Mafia.
He's a wooster. Likes to kidnap black teenagers and take them out to the bayou. After starving them for a few days, he cuts them loose, tells them to run. Sometimes he brings out the dogs, you know, for old time's sake. That's how he killed my sister. This is all I have left.
How do I find him?
It's still dangerous around here for him, so he stays on the move. But his men operate out of the community church in the old theater, Pearl as it used to be called.
It was named after Sammy's wife. I'm taking it down first.
One of my men have been staking it out. Seeing what he can learn about how it's being run, you should talk to him and see what he knows.
Once I deal with it, I'll see about the church.
You spot anything you can miss?
If we seek peace and love, we'll find God. But if our...